Working in customer support is never easy. Working in tech support, I can't even imagine. Welcome to this episode of Tales from Tech Support. Our first tale is from LittleWing586. Got a ticket today to move the new guy from the training area to his desk. Got him all set up and went back to my desk. It's nearing the end of the day and I'm counting down the minutes until the weekend is here. Behind me, I hear a voice but can't make out who it is because of my earbud in one ear. It's the new guy, and he walks right up to my desk. My back faces the entryway of the office, which I absolutely hate for this reason. He stands there beside me, like a foot away, and points at the computer on my desk and says, "Can I take the Logitech thing out of the front of my computer?" His arm still raised, pointing at my computer as he stops talking. What Logitech thing? I turn around and look at my computer because I have nothing Logitech, and then look at his arm in front of my face just over my desk. Then it dawns on me. He got a computer with a wireless mouse, and the Logitech receiver sits in the front USB port. No, that's for your mouse, your wireless mouse. You can see the blank look on his face as he stares at me. The train is arriving into the station. The light is finally on after hitting the light switch. "Oh," he says as he finally puts down his arm. "Yeah, 'cause it's not Bluetooth," I say as he walks back to his desk, I presume. Not sure why it bothered him, but alright. I think a lot of people just assume the wireless keyboards and mice come with technology and that there's nothing that makes them work outside of the computer itself. In this case, they learn that yes, they do in fact still utilize a receiver. This next tale is by Hoshigetsu. Have a guy call me to tell me he couldn't open a PDF attachment that my company has been sending him. We've been sending the files as PDF for as long as we've had the system, which is going on 3 years now. Our emails send out a link to download Acrobat Reader for those less tech savvy.
"I can't open the file you sent me from my email."
"What seems to be your specific issue in opening it?"
"It keeps telling me I have to pay for the program, Acrobat DC.
"Well, you can download Acrobat Reader and open the file in that, or use Microsoft Edge."
"Well, I've never had issues opening it on my phones before this month."
Me suddenly confused by no context of opening it on mobile. Well, your phone should have a PDF reader built in to easily see the file. Just click on the file in your email.
"I clicked the link."
Alright, so you've downloaded Acrobat Reader app, I'm assuming then.
"Yes, and it wants me to pay."
After some testing, I realized that it prompts you to try and buy Acrobat DC on the Acrobat Reader app. You can just X out and use the free version easily. You do not have to pay for it. Please click the X and use the version.
"When I do, that closes the app."
Alright, let's try to open the preview in your email. Click on the attachment.
"There's no attachment."
Alright, I will send again. I could see the attachments when I send from our system, so I know they're there at this point. Caller still fiddling with old email.
"I could see the documents on my computer."
So the attachment is in the email?
"On the computer it is, but not on my phone."
There was a long silence before I decided it was worth the argument. "It's definitely on your phone."
"It's not there."
"It really is. If it's on your computer email, it's on your phone email."
"I have eyes, you know."
"I understand. So can you see the file on your phone?"
"No, I cannot."
"Keep looking. What email application or provider do you have?"
"I don't know. My email is here at yahoo.com.
He gets frustrated and tells me after an hour of back and forth, he gives up and we end the call. I sign into my Yahoo Mail to locate the attachment location and get ready to email him a screenshot from my mobile. He called back to tell me open the new email I sent him, prompted him for an application to open the attachment he finally located, and he opened it in Word. I get that some people just aren't tech savvy and they don't realize that you don't have to pay for every single program, that there are still certain uses with the free software. At least in the end, this all worked itself out. This next tale is from Flairkin101. So the customer phone's help desk gets me and the conversation goes like this.
Thanks for calling the service desk. Like, badly underpaid me speaking. How can I help you?
I don't know what I've done, but my tablet says it's in safe mode and won't do anything.
No problem. Just restart the tablet.
I don't know how it happened or how to get it to work. I'm a dinosaur.
Easy enough. Restarting the tablet will do it.
How these things work are a mystery to me. I've no idea how to fix it.
Well, not everyone is techie, but if you restart the tablet, it'll be fine.
I need this fixed. I can't work without it.
Restarting the tablet will take it out of safe mode.
I have to have this. It's how I record my work.
I don't know if this line is very good. Can you hear me?
Yes, I hear you.
Great. Please, can you restart the tablet?
We use app for recording our work, you see, so I can't be without it.
Yes, I know this is vital to you guys. Has the tablet restarted yet?
Would restarting it help?
Absolutely. Give it a go.
I think I should try to restart it.
Yes, go for it.
It's restarting. Oh, it's working now.
Glad to hear it.
How come you didn't think of that? Maybe I should be doing your job.
Maybe. Thanks for calling. I'll email you the ticket reference if you give me your name.
Bye.
I love how at the end of this, the caller acts like they were the genius the whole time when in reality, they were just too busy talking to take 2 seconds to listen. This next tale is by Radages. We're running an extended pilot with some new cell phones and MDM software on it. The MDM solution allows the support company to do all kinds of neat stuff, including a remote control option. But as many stories do, this one starts with a ticket. This one labeled, Phone 266 isn't working. The ticket has some of the necessary info, mainly that the IQ app, the MDM one, doesn't allow them to log in, stating that the PIN code is incorrect. Well, I can't do anything with these phones, so I bump the ticket to the supplier, and they quickly respond. I mean, these guys are really quick. If we can turn the phone on so they can log in remotely and see what's what. I inform the user, turn the phone on, then call the supplier's number, and from then on, they will take over. To which I get the genius reply,
sorry, but this phone belongs to the night shift. I made the report while working. It's always off during the daytime.
So basically what this person is saying is they don't care if the phone gets fixed, they only care if it gets fixed while they're working, as opposed to making sure they go into work with a working phone. Very counterproductive, but I also see a very lazy employee. And our final tale is from McNulty BPD. So I stated in another post on this sub that I work for an international robotics company, specifically in our service department. We're responsible for any hardware issues that arise and go to local sites to fix stuff or source techs to go to sites out of state. I myself am the senior most person in our department and will soon be replacing my boss since he is retiring this week. For the past 2 months, I've been working the overnight shift all by myself. Help desk is there too, of course, but I mainly do everything on my own, from getting stuff ready for shipping to working with techs over the phone. Nothing too difficult. Well, last night, I was on the phone with a tech from a site in Finland. Let's call the guy Lars, his middle name actually. We have his full name in our records. He is absolutely the biggest sweetheart you can imagine. Always kind, gentle, upbeat, respectful, etc. Not a bad word you can say about him. So I was on the phone with him for about a half hour and he was doing some relatively easy fix. Replacing a front panel cover on the robot as the original had been cracked after someone hit it with a hospital bed. I say relatively easy because there are a lot of screws that have to be threaded very carefully and can be tricky to get them to catch and tighten. It was just funny hearing him, anytime he strained, swear loudly even when he set the phone down. I tried using Translate on my phone and got words like Vitu, Hora, and Kirpa. I'll let y'all look those up. I myself had my phone on mute and was laughing up a storm. I especially laughed when he would walk away for a second or two and I'd hear him swearing in the distance. But again, this guy is such a sweetheart and did everything right with regards to fixing it. I love just talking to him about his personal life, also like his kids that are in college, where he and his wife are going on holiday, etc.
Great guy. Wish I could meet in person. That's such a great story. It must be great knowing that you actually can deal with people in your company and they're not 100% incompetent. And in this case, they can actually give you a really good laugh and just be an all-around good person. Alright, that's enough tales for the day. Well, that wraps up this episode of Tales from Tech Support. If you liked the video, please drop a like, share my content on all of your social media, subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to hit that bell so you're notified every time I upload. And drop a comment down below. It really helps with the algorithm. Thanks for watching. Thanks to my patrons. Have a great day and stay safe out there.